I suppose that I can't swing all round with the back of their collar. If these things were masterworks, you better tell you know. Masterworks are meant to be looked at for nothing. No how.
Contrarywise, if you think we're alive, you ought to speak.
I'm sure I'm very sorry.
I know you're thinking though. Is it so?
No how.
Contrarywise, if it was so, it might be. If it were so, it would be. But it isn't. It ain't that logic.
I remember which is the best way of this flood, as it's coming on very dark. They look so like a couple of schoolboys.
First boy.
No how.
Next boy. Contrary wise.
At any rate, it's getting dark, and I would like to know which is the best way to get out of
this. You like poetry?
Yes, pretty well. Some poetry.
What shall we repeat to her?
The bard and the carpenter, that's the longest!
It's very long. Would you mind telling me it's wrong?
The sun was shining on the sea,
shining all his might. He did his very best to make the billow smooth and bright.
And Cezanne, because it was
the middle of the night.
The waters and the carpenter walking close at hand. They looked like anything seems to be watching
if this were only cleared away,
they said, it would be grand.
A oysters come and walk.
The walrus did beseech a pleasant walk, a pleasant talk among the briny beach.
We cannot do with more than four if you give a hand to eat. The eldest oyster looked at him, but never a word he said. The eldest oyster winked his eye and shook his heavy head, meaning to say he did not choose to leave the oyster bed.
But four young oysters hurried up, all eager for the treat. Their coats were brushed, faces washed, and their shoes were clean and neat. And Zazan, because you know they haven't any feet. Four other oysters followed them, and yet another four. And thick and fast they came at last, and more and more and more.
All hopping through the frothy waves and scrambling to the shore. The walrus and the carpenter walked on a mile or so, and then they rested on a rock,
conveniently low.
And all the little oysters stood and waited in a row.
The time has come, the walrus said, to talk of many things. Of shoes and ships and sealing wax, of cabbages
and kings.
And whether the seas boiling hot or the figs that wouldn't.
A loaf of bread, the walrus said, is chiefly what we need.
Pepper and vinegar, besides, are very good indeed.
Now if you're ready, oysters dear,
we can begin to eat.
But not on us, the oysters cried, turning a little blue.
After such kind, that would be a dismal thing to do.
The night is fine, the walrus said. Do you admire the view?
It seems a shame, the walrus said, to play them such a trick. So we brought them out so far and made them drop so quick.
The carpenter said nothing but, the butter spread thick! I weep for you, the walrus said, I deeply sympathize.
All the turtles were stuffed. Those are the largest size. We'll get a pocket handkerchief before the screen eyes.
Oh, oyster, said the carpenter.
You've had a pleasant run. Shall we be trotting home again?
But the answer came there none.
The answer came there none.
And this was scarcely all,
because they eaten every one.
I like the ball less because she was a little sorry
for oyster. He ate more than the carpenter, though. You see, he held his pocket handkerchief in front, so the carpenter couldn't count how many he took.
That was neat. Then I asked the walrus, the carpenter, best. If he didn't eat as many as the walrus did.
But he ate as many as he did.
Very well. They were both very unpleasant characters.
At any rate, it's coming on very dark. What?
And would you mind telling me which road is the quickest way out of this mud?
Do you think it's going to rain?
No, I don't think it is. At least not under here.
No, pal. But will it rain outside?
In many cases, we've no objections.
Contrary-wise.
Got enough five. You're splashing paint over me with that.
I can help it. Seven jabbed my elbow.
Oh, go ahead, five. Always lay the blame on others.
You better not.
What for?
That's none of your business.
Yes, it is his business, and I'll tell him it was for giving the cook tulip roots instead of onions.
Of all the unjust things.
Would you tell me, please, why you were painting those roses?
Well, you see, miss, this ought to have been a red rose tree.
we put in a white one by mistake. And if the queen was to find out, well, we'd all have our heads chopped off, you know?
The queen! The queen!
Have you seen the Mock Turtle yet?
I don't even know what a mock turtle is.
It's the thing mock turtle soup is made from.
I never saw one nor heard of one.
Come on, then. He will tell you his history. Griffon! Griffon! Up, lady thing, and take this young lady to see the mock turtle and to hear his history.
What fun.
What is the fun?
Why, it's all her. It's all a fancy, you know? It's nobody. Come on.
I was never so worried about it in all my life. Never! What is
sorrow? Has it got no sorrow, you know? It's all a fancy. This here, young lady, she wants to know about your history, she do.
I'll tell her. Sit down, both of you, and don't speak a word till I finish. Once, I was a real turtle. When we were little, we went to school to see. Our master was an old turtle. We called him Tortoise.
Why did you call him Tortoise? It wasn't one.
We called him Tortoise because he taught us. Really, you're very dull.
You better be ashamed of yourself for asking such a simple question. Drive on, old fellow. We haven't got to obey.
Yes, we went to school and see, though you need to believe it.
I never said I didn't.
You did.
Hold your tongue.
We had the best of educations. In fact, we went to school every day.
I did today's school, too. Being so proud of that.
With extras?
Yes, French and music.
And washing?
Certainly not.
Then yours wasn't a very good school then. At ours, they had a few in the bill. French, music, and washing. Extra.
We wanted that much, but we went to Bonn to see.
Unfortunately, I couldn't afford it. I can only take the regular courses.
What was that?
Reading and writing, of course, followed by the different branches of arithmetic, vision, distraction, uglification, and derision.
I never heard of uglification. What is it?
Never heard of uglification? You know what it is to beautify, don't you?
It means to make anything pretty.
Well, then, if you don't know what it is to uglify, you are a simpleton.
And how many hours a day do you do lessons?
10 hours the first day, 9 next, and so on.
What a curious bird!
That's why they're called lessons, because they're lessons from day to day.
Then the 11th day must have been a holiday.
Of course it was.
But how ever did he manage on the 12th?
Oh, that's enough about lessons. Why don't we talk about the lobster claw drum then? The games now. See, there's a bone in my throat.
Yes, thank you. But you might live much under the sea.
I haven't.
Perhaps you were never introduced to a lobster before.
I once tasted it. No! Never!
So you have no idea what a delightful thing a lobster culture is to you.
No, indeed. What's my appearance?
Would you like to see it?
Very much indeed.
Let's try the first thing. We could do the lobster without the lobsters. Which shall I say?
Oh, you sing. I forgot my words.
All right. Will you walk a little faster, instead of waiting to a snail? There's a porpoise close behind us, and he's treading on my tail. See how eagerly the lobsters and the turtles are advanced. They're waiting on a shoe. Won't you come and join the dance? Will you, won't you, will you, won't you, will you join the dance? Will you, won't you, will you, won't you, will you join the dance? There's really no notion how delightful it will be when they pick us up and throw us with the lobsters out to sea. Both the raffle meagle and the artist to France. Turn our pair the words, now will you join the dance? Will you, won't you, will you, won't you, will you join the dance? Will you, won't you, will you, won't you, won't you join the dance?
Thank you. And I do love the story you've cut about the whiting.
Oh, ask for the whiting. You've seen them, of course.
Yes, I've often seen them at dinner.
So, I don't know where Din came from, but if you've seen them so much, of course you know what they look like.
Do you know why it's called a whiting?
No, I never thought of it. Why is that?
Because it does the boots and shoes.
Does the boots and shoes?
Yes. Shoes under the sea are done with whiting. Now you know.
If I did the whiting on the side, I'd pull the porpoise back.
You don't want to come along. Oh, yeah, my chapel. No, why we should go anywhere without a porpoise.
Wasn't it really?
Why, of course not. Why, if a fish came to tell me that he was going on a journey, I would ask, with what porpoise?
Don't you mean purpose?
I mean what I say.
That's enough about the game. Would you like the mock turtle sing another song or another verse of the lobster quadrille?
Oh, a song. If the mock turtle be so kind.
All right. You beautiful sir.
Your hat.
This is mine.
Stolen! I keep them to sell. I'm a hunter.
Give your evidence and don't be nervous, or I'll have you executed on the spot.
Bring me a list of the singers in the last concert.
Give your evidence and don't be nervous, or I'll have you executed whether you're nervous or not.
I'm a poor girl, Your Majesty, and I hadn't but just begun my tea. Not above a week or so ago. And with the bread and butter getting so thin, and the twinkling of the tea.
Twinkling of what?
It began with the tea.
Of course, twinkling begins with the tea. Do you take me for some dunce? If that's all you know, you may stand down.
I can't go to Laura. I'm on the floor as is.
Then you may sit down.
I'd rather finish my tea.
You may go.
Just take his health outside.
Consider your verdict.
They told me you had been to her and mentioned me to him. She gave me a good character but said I could not swim. He sent them word I had not gone. We know it to be true. If she should push the matter on, what would become of you? I gave her one, they gave him two. You gave us bigger more. They all returned from him to you, though they were mine before. I gave her one, they gave him two. You gave us bigger more. They all returned from him to you, though they were mine before. If I or she should chance to be involved in this affair, he trusts to you to set them free exactly as we were. He trusts to you to set them free exactly as we were. My notion was that you had been, before she had this fit, an obstacle that came between him and ourselves and it. An obstacle that came between him and ourselves and it. Don't let him know she liked him best before this must ever be. A secret kept from all the rest between yourself and me. A secret kept from all the rest between yourself and me.
That's the most important evidence we've heard yet.
I don't believe it can add any meaning. If any of them can explain it, I'll give them 50 cents.
She doesn't believe there's an atom of meaning in it.
If there's no meaning in it, that saves the world trouble, for we need to find any. But still, I seem to see something after all. I said I could not swim. She can't swim, can you?
Do I look like it?
All right, so far, we know it to be true. That's jury, of course. I gave her one, they gave him two. That must have been when you're done with the tarts, you know?
But it goes on, they all returned from him to you.
Why, there they are. Nothing can be clearer than that.
Then again, before she had a fit, you never had a fit in your hair.
Never! Then the words don't fit you. It's a pun.
It's a lie.
What do you know about this business?
Nothing.
Nothing whatever?
Nothing whatever.
That's a very important
pun. Important, Your Majesty. Of course.
Yes, yes.
Unimportant.
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 Yes, yes, to be sure. Now let the jury consider their verdict.
Not yet, not yet. Sentence first, verdict afterwards.
Stop it, nonsense. The idea of having the sentence first.
Hold your tongue.
I won't.
Off with their head.
Who cares for you? You're nothing but a cap of corn!
goodbye, and Dad'd be very thankful.
Yeah.